Hello everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So today is the starting day of a new month and we have new pivot points. Not only this month but this week also, today is the new day of this week, so we have new weekly pivot points as well. So first of all, on daily time frame, we know that this candle on 23rd May, it made a high and a low, and those are acting as the support and resistance for Nifty. So the resistance level is around 12,041, and on 31st May also, that is the last trading day, we saw that from around that level itself Nifty faced a price rejection. So today also price is trying to approach that level. On daily time frame you don't have a pivot point or any resistance as such, but natural resistance is of course there. But when you move to the hourly chart, that is on 60 minute time frame, there is a weekly R1 at 12,040. So the prior resistance of 23rd May and then the resistance of 31st May. Along with that, you have weekly R1 at 12,040. So these three things combined, that price level is now acting as a very strong resistance. So Nifty is bullish only above this 12,041. So on weekly basis, if it goes above that range, then the next target will immediately be 12,150. Now on Wednesday, there's a holiday because of Ramzan, and Thursday you have weekly expiry. So keeping all these things in your mind, you need to take positions. So here one thing is clearly visible to us: natural resistance in conjunction with weekly R1 at 12,040 is going to act as a strong resistance to Nifty, and it is going to be bullish only above that. Otherwise, if we observe any bearish candlestick pattern along with reduced OI, so here price is increasing, in the same way if the OI is decreasing, then that is definitely a signal for reversal. So these are all things we need to combine, but as of now 12,040 is going to act as resistance for Nifty. And then going to Bank Nifty, so Bank Nifty natural resistance is around 31,786 and pivot resistance is around 31,900. So this zone, 200 point zone, is going to act as a strong resistance to Bank Nifty on the upside. So we can expect Bank Nifty to go up till this zone and then it might face a rejection, but here in between you don't have any resistance to Bank Nifty. On daily time frame, there's no resistance for Bank Nifty on daily time frame from pivot point side. So even in Bank Nifty you have new pivot points, but you also need to see the distance between the pivot points. When there is a large distance between the pivot points, hardly price goes up or down. See here, this is one such example. In the month of April, there is a distance, large distance between pivot point and R1, and if you see, price did not even try to touch R1. But when the distance between the pivot point and R1 is very much less, or pivot point and S1 is very less, it will definitely go and try to touch it. Even here also, distance between pivot point and R1 less, and it tried to touch. Here the distance is moderately high, so it just touched and it reversed. Here distance between pivot point and S1 is very large, so it did not even try to come down. So this is how price reacts. So what does that mean when there is lesser distance? If there is less distance, that means there is lesser volatility, and that signals that people are actually preparing for a bigger movement. So Nifty and Bank Nifty, the resistances are very clear to us. On hourly time frame, both the indices are facing resistance, and above that resistance, price is going to be bullish. Otherwise, it might take a U-turn at this zone. Then coming to the heavyweights, first is HDFC Bank. So it started its journey above the central pivot point itself. So that's a bullish sign. And does it have any resistance on the upside? As per price, the high of 31st May itself is the resistance, which is 2465. So here we are not getting a clear signal. Let's jump to hourly time frame and see. So for the price, R1 2474 and the prior natural resistance 2464. So this 10 rupee zone is going to act as a strong resistance for HDFC Bank. So when HDFC Bank goes up, we know that it is going to drag Nifty and Bank Nifty also in its direction, because indices depend upon stocks. Stocks does not depend upon index. So this was HDFC Bank. Then you have Reliance. So here you have a trend line resistance, and price is nowhere near to that. But even Reliance is also, it opened above the central pivot point. So in this stock also, it's a bullish signal. So all the stocks are trading above central pivot point. So we cannot be completely on bearish side. We need to be neutral this month. So in whichever direction it goes, on the upside or on the downside, we'll need to be in that direction. So here, the central pivot point trading above that on daily time frame, this is going to be the immediate resistance. And coming to hourly time frame, yeah, so in Reliance there is no clear signal, but yes, of course, it is facing a resistance at R1 as of now. We'll need to wait and see. And then coming to HDFC. And HDFC is also at a conjunction of resistances, the R1 and the prior top. So this 5 rupees zone is a strong resistance to HDFC. If today's first candle's high is taken out, 2220 is the price level. If 2220 is taken out, HDFC is going to be strongly bullish. On daily time frame, it does not have a resistance, and even on hourly time frame, only 2220 is going to act as a resistance. Otherwise, there is no resistance for HDFC. So all these stocks, all the major stocks in Nifty, they are showing bullishness. Only thing is, we need to wait until the immediate resistances are taken out. So that's it for today's market commentary. Thank you all for joining.